Welcome to the Way to Go podcast. I am Bill McMinn along with Mark Hosteller talking about enjoying your summer actually in this podcast because the Bible says that we should do good and be happy. And so I want to talk about that. But I was actually looking this morning, the I would say incentive for the show, the catalyst, the inspiration. I was looking at a photo of the sun setting that I'd taken, and I was just reflecting on it, and I've been out on the lake. It's perfectly flat. It was like glass. It was unbelievable. The Lake Erie was actually mirroring the clouds in the sky. It was, you hardly ever see it like that. And so I took this picture of the sunset, and I was looking at it, and I was just reminding myself, yeah, you got to take time to enjoy life too.
Yeah.
And I've got a lot to do. I mean, I've already, with a friend of mine, Mike Emerson, have, you know, he did a lot. I kind of stood there and helped him a little, rebuilding our deck. And we got another part of one to do. And so I have that, and I have to paint the back of my house, and, you know, I have to mulch, and, you know, I have a lot of work to do. I'm sure you do too, but I don't want to just work and not do things with my family, not do things with my wife. And I think it's so important for her and I, to be out there.
Bill, you inspire me. I mean, honestly, the things that you do, you have a photographer's mindset, so right. you will pause and take in things that I would just go right by, you right. know? And I appreciate that about right. you. You know, you're teaching me how to just stop for you right. know, a sunset.
Right.
That means a lot, you know? Just take it in. What's right. it going to take? 5 minutes?
Right.
Stop. And stop for 5 minutes and take it in, you know,
yeah, appreciate
the beauty of it, you know,
in different angles. It's always interesting too. It's constantly changing. Like if you ever see something really cool in the sky, it could be a rainbow, could be a partial rainbow between two clouds. Could be the way the yeah. sun is setting, could be a cloud. Take the picture now. 5 minutes is going to be different.
You're right.
It never stays. The cloud you're shapes, looking at, you know? The earth is spinning, the clouds are moving.
Yeah.
It is constantly changing. And so even when you're out there, you have a good eye, by the way, of like once you're out there a lot, like you know which way you need to shoot from. Like if a ship's passing by, you know you want to be the sun hitting it. So the sun's behind you when you take the picture. You don't want the sun coming into you when you take, or all you're going to see is a silhouette. So there's certain things you know, like you know on a glassy day what side of the boat's going to be reflecting and what side's not going to reflect. Things like that, because of the way the light's coming in and how the light's going to bounce, you kind of figure it out. But you have to look around all the time.
Right.
You have to pay attention in front of you, behind you, and around you to be looking for those exceptionally beautiful moments.
Yeah.
Because sometimes in life, it comes down to it's just a beautiful moment.
Some people have that eye, like you. My wife's right. a photographer. She loves taking pictures and stuff. I mean, she'll capture clouds because she knows they're going to be gone. You know, right. so she'll click on, you know, and be like, see this thing? And I can't even see it, man. I'm right. like, what? That's a cloud. You know what I mean? Right. I can't see beyond it, you know, but man, I enjoy it. Right. I enjoy that you guys, it's inspiring for me. And I want to learn how to enjoy those moments more,
you know? See, the thing is, this is the way I look at it. We're not at the Garden of Eden, okay? And the Garden of Eden was perfection. It was beautiful and had the trees and whatnot, but we still have fruit trees and we still have grass. And I look at this world. I look at we have taste. We notice beautiful things.
Right.
We can hear music. There's intimacy, which we, you know, all like.
Yeah, and laughter.
Laughter,
you know,
humor. Yeah. All these senses that can be pleased, God put those there.
And they should be.
He put those there, right.
Yeah.
The concept of joy, the concept of enjoying things, concept of happiness is something that's built into this world. Why would I want to go through life, like Solomon says in Ecclesiastes, and not take joy even in my toil?
Yeah.
Not find satisfaction. If you can't, like you said, man, you're blown through life and you can't find satisfaction. And so I want to find satisfaction in the sunset. I want to find satisfaction in what I do. Now, he says, I like this verse and I want to work through this a little bit. Ecclesiastes 3:12-14. I know there's nothing better for people than to be happy and to do good while they live. Now, this has become a theme verse for me. If you see, if you find me on TikTok, you find me on Instagram, you find my Venture Vibe page on Facebook, you're going to see this verse, be happy and do good, because I think it does encapsulate a lot of what life is. I want to be happy. I also want to do good. I don't want to just be selfish. Yeah, you know, I want to be happy. I want to enjoy life, but I also want to do things that are good and productive. So I think it captures both.
He says, I find this phrase, nothing better for people.
Right.
That's a powerful statement,
right.
guys. Think about that. Nothing better for you than to enjoy your life.
Right.
I mean, Just go out and enjoy it.
And to do good.
Yeah, and to do good.
Each
yeah.
of them may eat and drink and find satisfaction in all their toil. This is a gift of God. Mm. All right, this yeah. is God's gift to you. I know that everything God does will endure forever. Nothing can be added to it and nothing taken away from it. God does it so that people will fear him. Mm. So eat, drink, find satisfaction in your toil. That's a gift from God too. And I find like today, all right, today, my mind is on many things. You know, I think of the things I love to do and my hobbies, and you come to work. And I had to remind myself as I come in, you have work to do. Mm-hmm. Get after it.
Yeah.
Do you know what I'm saying? Get after yeah. it. Get moving. And whether that's the work of praying, it's the work of writing these podcasts, it's the way of sitting down and, you know, whatever, or, you know, letting someone know, I let a friend know that I was praying for them today. You know, whatever the work is, get busy, man. Get after it, because there's joy in that too. I mean, that's a gift from God to find satisfaction.
Absolutely.
And then he says, you know, everything God does will endure forever. You can't add or take away. And God does it so that people will fear him. Now, he's already said that, you know, we can't figure everything out, but God has set eternity in the hearts of men. Mm-hmm. We don't understand everything that we see. We know that from another verse in Ecclesiastes 2. So we will fear him. And I think one of the problems in life is that people, and why we're not finding happiness, is we're not fearing God.
Yeah, absolutely. Holiness leads to happiness.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? If you're trying to attain happiness outside of holiness and holy living and fearing God, it's going to end up short every
time.
Be
good.
You know, just Do what God tells you to
right.
do.
Do
and
good.
You're going to be happy.
Right.
You know?
Do good. That's helpful things to people. That's morally right. So we can split mm-hmm. two good into two things. There's the morality part of it, like you mm-hmm. said, being like God, be holy for I am holy. There's also the part of it that's doing good that would be the acts of service like Jesus Christ did. You know, you're just doing absolutely. Something that help someone else. So I look at that and say, yeah, I mean, there's no doubt. I mean, we should be doing things that are the right things to do because there's happiness found in that. But I also want to look at another aspect of it though, Mark. If you fear God, right?
Mm-hmm.
You trust him. You trust him to put certain things in your life. You trust him to do things that God does, right?
Mm-hmm.
So there was a shooting out at San Jose, I believe, and yeah. 9 people have lost their lives. And it's a tragic, and we see this constantly. Somebody's taking a gun to school, to work, to a neighborhood, to a party. People are getting shot, police officers, the whole nine yards. If you ask me, Bill, do you think that if people feared God, some of that would end? Yes. And here's why I would say that. Because that guy who's disgruntled with his work, so he goes and shoots the place up, he's upset about something. He's angry about something. He's not mm-hmm. thinking God will take care of this. Vengeance is not mine.
That's
the Bible
right.
says, vengeance is mine, saith the Lord.
That's right.
He will repay. My job is to return evil with good. Like, that's my job. If I feel like I'm getting doses of evil, I need to return good for it, right?
That goes right along with Galatians 6:9. I just looked it up. So we must not grow weary in doing good. Why? Because in due time, we will reap if we do not give up.
Right.
We will reap what we're doing good.
Right.
If you sow good, you're going to reap good.
I agree.
You know what I'm saying? That's a principle in scripture that's always true.
Yeah.
You reap what you sow.
Right.
And so I completely agree, man. If you fear the Lord and you just honor him, stay faithful to him, do what's right, man, your life's going to be blessed.
It is. Know? And there's a God component that I'm not trying to do God's work. I'm not trying to force people to do anything. I'm not getting angry. And by the way, listen, yes, all of us get upset. All of us struggle.
Yeah.
All of us have, you know, bad attitudes at times. All of us. I mean, we struggle with weariness. We struggle emotionally sometimes. Not that we have emotional problems always, but it's just, you know, we're tired and worn out and a little grumpier, right?
Mm-hmm.
Maybe some people are in pain. They get a little grumpy. I see that. But this violence, this is outright reading about kids getting shot in road rage. I'm telling you, there is no fear of God in this country, because if there was, that wouldn't happen, Mark.
That's right.
It would not happen, because everyone would know God will take care of this. God's got this. I just need to behave myself. I need to trust God. And as man is trying to more and more take control of that steering wheel, like these people trying to control justice, they're trying to control what they think should be happening.
Yeah.
We are getting out of control. As people try to grasp control of the society, and take matters into their own hands, we become less in control of this world, and it becomes more and more of a dangerous place. So I look at, I appreciate what he says, be happy and do good.
Yeah.
Part of that is fearing God.
Mm-hmm.
God is bringing things in our lives. And I think that some of the things that are happening are allowed by God so that we will fear God. Because if this country can't see right now that we need to turn our tail ends back to God and get it right, start some praying, man. I mean, start some, get into your word, you know, start getting some truth into you and into your kids. Come on, let's go, right?
Absolutely. I mean, it's a sad thing to, when you say enjoy in the summer, it's a sad thing to not trust that you're going to be okay going to the beach.
Right.
Or going on vacation. You know, we just went down to the Ark Encounter and Creation Museum and had a great time down there. But in your mind, when you're on that bus going down to the Ark, you can't help but think, is there some kind of person on here that's crazy? You know what I mean? Like, are we okay here?
Yeah.
You know, as a protector of my family, that's constantly going through my mind.
Right.
I'm always like, scanning. Are we all right here? You know?
Well, like they say, there's no police officer that will ever go into a restaurant and turn his back to that door.
Yeah. Yeah. And that's a sad thing.
Right.
Fear the Lord.
Right.
You know? If I know that you're fearing the Lord, I don't have to worry about you.
Right.
Because I know you're wanting God's purposes to be fulfilled in your life. You know? You're wanting righteousness to be established. How much better are we going to enjoy each other and enjoy one another's company if I don't have to worry about you?
True.
You know?
And that's one point. And here's another one, too. And that is being happy. It's just like he says, be happy and do good. Why would somebody want to be a Christian if we as Christians aren't happy?
That's right.
And I challenge myself on this all the time because there are certain things that make me unhappy. And then I have to challenge myself, well, Bill, what is your happiness based on? Mm. Maybe it's not based on the right things today. Right. But if I'm coming across like a grumpy son of a gun all the time, instead of, no, I love life, love the Lord, love my family. And we present ourselves a certain way. You know, for some people, I look at them and say, you are the kind of person that makes me not want to be a Christian. Your attitude makes me want to not be here and around here. It's your grumpiness, your bitterness, your refusal to do what's right. Those are the kind of things I think that are really telling and at times a problem.
Yeah.
Right. So I want to look at being a Christian and saying, no, I think being a happy Christian, allowing God to fill my heart with joy when joy is indeed a fruit of the Holy Spirit, is pretty stinking important.
I believe happiness is a byproduct of contentment. When you're content, man, just be content in the God who loves you and has given you everything. Like you said in the last podcast, you know, you praise the Lord. He created you in America.
Right.
You know what I mean? That's one reason just to be happy. Like you're in America, you're in a free country, you know? Happiness, I think a lot of times we end up making our situations and our circumstances
everything
the Lord of our happiness.
I agree.
You know, and that should not be.
But I'm guilty of that too sometimes. I mean, I am guilty because here's a lot of our problems. A lot of our problems happen between the left ear and the right ear, and that's just the truth. And it's just, it's the way we think about it. It's the value that we place on certain things that maybe God doesn't place value on. We got to live life, do the best. I have a phrase, I've said it over and over, I take life as it comes. And man, life has dished some wicked curveballs at me. And there are times I've had to pray through these things, get down on my knees. I've seen God do great things. Mark and I have had opportunities to pray about things.
Yeah.
We've seen great things happen in people's lives just because we're trusting God. We had a friend that we were praying for that's really struggling and going through a lot of problems. I said, Mark, we need to pray for this person today. Yeah. We prayed. And then I think you were gone the next morning. So I saw the results of it later that night. I saw that God was answering that prayer and how God had answered that prayer. And then I told you about it the next day. I knew you were away, so I didn't go into detail. I just said, hey, God answered our prayers.
Yeah.
And that made me feel good because, hey, you and I went to God, we prayed about it, and God answered those prayers.
Yeah.
And we prayed for the spaghetti dinner the Eucharist was having. You and I got up on that stage, we prayed about that spaghetti dinner. They broke their record.
They broke their record. Prayer. I mean, thank you to all that came and supported that as well. But I mean, so you're talking about enjoying the summer. We're talking about being happy. So in practical application, I mean, when you go out, you set your mind on a day to go to the beach, whatever.
Sure.
And halfway through the day, it starts raining.
Right.
You have a choice to make.
Right. Agreed.
You have a choice to make.
Amen.
Is this going to ruin my entire day?
Right.
Or can I be happy and just adjust my plans a little bit, be content with what we have here, and let's make the most of it. Right?
I agree 100%. And that's where the between the left ear and the right ear comes in, because you have to be trusting God. You have to be happy, do good. You have to trust the Lord that he's got all these things figured out. And then maybe he just doesn't want that to happen. I had a big miss on something the other day. My wife and I had a conversation this morning. Well, it must not have been God's will, right? I mean, so that's how it is. Be happy. Ecclesiastes 5:18-21.
Be happy. Sorry. Yeah, go ahead.
This is what I've observed to be good. That it is appropriate for a person to eat and drink and find satisfaction in their toilsome labor under the sun during the few days of life God has given them, for this is their lot. Moreover, when God gives someone wealth and possessions and the ability to enjoy them, to accept their lot and be happy in their toil, this is a gift from God. They seldom reflect on the days of their life because God keeps them occupied with gladness of heart. And I appreciate that, because I don't believe we're going to find contentment without our faith. I think faith is a huge part of finding enjoyment in the summer, enjoying God, knowing that, I think to me, knowing that God wants me to enjoy the world.
Absolutely.
I think thinking about God and these things, like I am a huge nature seeker, by the way. I'm a huge get out and kayak. My plan, if God allows me to live through the summer, I mean, my plan is that, and I'm not sick, by the way, I'm just saying I don't like to boast about what I'm doing without acknowledging God. It's up to God, right? But yeah, I plan on, you know, being a North Coast photographer on a kayak and being at all different places along the North Coast, being in some places out in New York State too, just to get out there on that kayak and enjoy it and see the beauty around me, because I'm only going through this place one time. And my wife and I, we just like to get out, not every day, but, you know, a couple days a week, you know, we like to get the kayak out, throw it in the back of the truck and move and go see something.
Absolutely, man.
I enjoy it. You might not enjoy that. You might enjoy just taking a walk. You might enjoy a bike ride. You might enjoy skateboards. You might enjoy rollerblading. You might enjoy going to get an ice cream, and that's fine too. Mm-hmm. But, you know, maybe have a bowl of ice cream out in the back of your deck and listen to the you know, peepers and the crickets and all that stuff, and this all the summer noisemakers, bullfrogs, right? Whatever's going on. But tune in to this beautiful world.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, for me and my family, we absolutely love getting together with friends, chilling out, you know, around a campfire and just having great times of fellowship. Right. It's one of our favorite things to do. I mean, that's what fills us, you know, energizes us. I mean, I love that, you know, but I wanted to come back with what you just said there about contentment, because you said to fear the Lord here. And I agree 100%, because there's a scripture. I can't remember exactly the reference right off the top of my head. It says godliness with contentment is great.
First Timothy 6.
Perfect. Yeah. Godliness with contentment is great gain for you.
Right.
Be godly, be content. You're going to have gain in your life, you know? And the other thing I was thinking about was, I think it's in Job, where it says, the joy of the Lord is my strength.
Nehemiah,
there you go. Yep. See, and so it wasn't the love of the Lord. It wasn't the faithfulness of the Lord. Those are great things. Right. I am not minimizing that. It's the joy of the Lord.
That's our strength,
you know? And I just think it's so important to come back to that heart, that disposition of joy.
And they were mourning that day. I mean, I think it was like a revival. They were mourning, and God told them the joy of the Lord. And usually, by the way, Mark knows all kinds of references. Like Mark amazes me on how many Bible references he knows.
I appreciate your help. Thank you.
Yeah, but you hit a couple. Mm-hmm. Yeah, a couple ones there. Yeah, I know pretty well. But yeah, it's incredible, really, you know, when you think about the opportunity that we have, like you said, to enjoy life or not to enjoy life.
Yeah.
My challenge would be, as you go through the summer, I'm a workaholic. I'm a guy who can never stop. My engine, thank God, is absolutely huge. And it's just, I can just keep grinding through stuff, and it just doesn't say, a little bit slower maybe now these days, but I'll get stuff done once I get my mind to it. And I like to be busy. I can't, unless it's dark, you're probably not, in nice weather, you are not going to find me in the house. You're not going to find me sitting in the house on a nice day. Like that's not going to happen. And I want to enjoy, you know, I plant flowers to enjoy them. I planted a garden because I enjoy to eat those vegetables. I put planters all around my deck just because I enjoy it.
Absolutely, man. Right. And that's great. Your wife and you agree to that.
Right.
You know, and I think if you're a married couple, you have to agree. What do we like to do for fun?
Right.
And then go do it.
Right.
You know, have a date night every week. go right. do it. You know, right. if you can't do every week, do bi-weekly.
Right.
Find something you enjoy to do and go have fun. We have Geneva on the Lake has great things up there, you know, like a putt-putt golf and like you said, a kayaking, you know, harbor yak or whatever, you know, go up there, have fun with them.
Right.
You know, enjoy life. Go fishing with your kids. You know,
yeah, this the fishing's a great one. I do it all the time.
I really want to do with my boys is just get out and just enjoy some time fishing, you know. Go on a vacation. Like I said, me and my wife, we just got back from a four-day trip. You know, it's like 4 days, really. Yeah, it was a blast.
Yeah.
We had fun. We enjoyed it, man. It was a great time. We're looking forward to the Outer Banks in Labor Day, you know, Labor Day week. We're looking forward to go out there. Give yourself something to look forward to.
And I'm happy for you. I'm really, and by the way, one of the ways to be happy is to be happy for other people and their successes. Mm. And if someone, you get to see someone out for a nice dinner, stop complaining that they went out to a nice dinner and you couldn't. Just be happy they could, you know, because you're going to be a miserable person if you're miserable every time someone else is happy. Yeah, you know, that's your problem, not their problem. Mm-hmm. I look at it and say, yeah, you know, I want to make sure that I'm enjoying life, but I also want to make sure I'm productive. I want to be productive for the kingdom of God, and I want some time to go be free and spend time. And I'll tell you, the more I've spent a lot of time with my wife out on that kayak. I love her so much. And I feel like I love her more. Mm. Like she's my babe, you know, she's my wife. That doesn't happen if you're not spending time together. That's right. You know, if you're not making the time together to get out there and do things, you're not going to feel that same bond. The same as you, with you and your kids. Like I feel a bond with them. And same with my friends. You want to feel a bond with me? Do things with me. That's where my bond is. Yeah. That's my love language. Just do something.
Yeah.
Do something with
it. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? I showed you a picture yesterday of I had to make a riser out of my septic tank. You know, I made it out of brick and mortar and all of that. I got the boys out there. I got my wife out there. She's like, well, what am I going to do? I said, just give me something to look at, babe.
Right,
you know what I mean? I mean, just be there with me, you know? And the boys were able to mix up the mud. Chastity helped with that. And, you know, we were working, but it was, I enjoyed it, you know, and I hope they enjoyed it too, you know, but just spending time together, accomplishing a project together, one way to enjoy the summer, you know,
and absolutely.
It's just a choice you have to make, you know?
But make the time. And that's what I'm saying. Yeah. Work. Sure. Get things done. Sure. Every moment. And you couldn't be happy. You couldn't enjoy. Yeah. Enjoy the toil, but take that time too to break, because why are you killing yourself? Ecclesiastes will talk about it. Solomon talks about it. Why are you killing yourself out there too? For what? For what? Sometimes see people do it. For what?
So
what in the world are we chasing? So get out there, enjoy your life. Let us know. You know, if you ever need any help with anything. Also, you can send us a note and say, hey, guess what? Here's how I enjoyed my life. We'll be happy to hear from you.
Yeah.
So take care. You all have a great week. God bless.